Melissa from Inspire Me ASAP, and in my last video, I explained the difference between synchronous and asynchronous learning, and also shared with you a remote reading lesson that I taught to my own students via Zoom. The topic of today's video is teaching small groups remotely. Now, you might be wondering, how do you teach guided reading groups remotely? And that is a great question and what this video is all about today. Now that my students are in their 9th week, hard to believe, of remote learning, we are finally getting into our groove. The students know exactly what to expect for our reading lesson. I always begin with the reading mini lesson to the whole group. And in my last video, I demonstrated that the lesson of that mini lesson was to think about what you are reading and to share your thinking with others. Once we complete the whole group lesson, we then transition into our small group learning time. And there's a couple of ways to go about this in Zoom. One way to go about this is to put all of your students in the waiting room. The kids that will be in your guided reading group are invited back to the main Zoom group. The kids not working with you are doing asynchronous learning at that time. Another way you could do this is to create a breakout room for your students. I would recommend this way if you have several other teachers working with your students at the same time as you are, such as interventionists or the co-teacher. And then you can join the group of students that you want to meet with for guided reading. Now, the only drawback to this option is that there's no one in that main Zoom room session. So I like to go about it the first way. I like to put all of my students in a waiting room, and then those students who I want to meet with, I admit them back into that main Zoom session. Now, once you have your group of readers, or one reader if you're doing a reading conference, once you have them with you, then you are ready to begin your guided reading group. Now, just like I would in person, I always begin my reading group with a brief introduction of the story. So let's say I am reading Apples in the Fall, which was a level C. This would be, for example, a kindergarten reading level. I might say to my students, boys and girls, today we are going to read a fun story called Apples in the Fall. And in this story, you're going to read all about some of the things that happen in the fall when it's time to pick apples. As you're reading, I want you to think about, so giving them a purpose as they are reading. Once an introduction and purpose is given, I then instruct my students to open Google Classroom to view the reading passage. Now on my end, I would open up Google Classroom. I would come under classwork, and you could see here how I already assigned some guided reading passages for my students, just to show you as like an example. So here I have Apples in the Fall, what I just shared with you, which would be perfect for my group of readers, that would be a C. I have here a story called Charlie's First Bath, which is a level K. And all of these digital or online reading passages, I assign to my students via Google Classroom. Now, if you're wondering how to go about to use Google Classroom to assign reading passages to your students, the good news for you is I have a 14-page free guide, absolutely free, free resource for you to learn how to step-by-step assign reading passages to your students. And you can click on the link below this video to find the link for that free Google guide, which will show you step by step, even with screenshots posted, to how to use this page right here for Google Classroom. Now, once my students are viewing the assignment in Google Classroom, they then independently start to read the story. So just like you would see right here on the screen, this is what my students would see. We would be on Zoom all together, And each student, each group, each student in my group of readers is viewing the same passage. And just like I would in person in my guided reading group, on Zoom, my students would then start to independently read this story. So for example, if my students that were at a level K, they would each have their passage pulled up from Google Classroom. I assigned it to them, and I would give them the brief introduction to the story, and then they would independently read the story. Now, when they were done reading the story, we would do exactly what we would do in person in class. We would then discuss the story, and we might answer the questions together. So I might say, boys and girls, Charlie was a Labrador retriever who loved to dig in the backyard. Was that true or false? Who can find evidence in the text to prove if that was true or false? So we might do some of these questions together, or I may assign these questions for their asynchronous learning time, and they may complete them independently. Now, in my next video, I'm going to show you how I hold a remote reading conference, again, via Zoom. In the meantime, please make sure that you go and download that free Google how-to guide, which is going to explain how to assign those passages or any passages in Google Classroom. If you are interested in my digital reading passages that I featured here in this video for your own students, you can check out my fiction and nonfiction passages that I have in digital and printable PDF format for grades K to 4, and I will put the link for that below. I hope that this was helpful to you, and in the meantime, you can go ahead and download that free Google guide. Thank you so much. Have a wonderful day.